When I came back from leave that March, everything looked the same, except that the countryside was already green. I saw the old church in a cup in the hills, and the mountains beyond, brown mountains with a little green on their slopes. The war had slowed down during the winter, but the troops still marched with heavily loaded cartridge boxes, bulging forward under their capes, as though they were 6 months gone with child. Our unit was still stationed in the town where we had been since autumn. I was very glad the Austrians seemed to want to come back sometime because they did not bombard it to destroy it, but only a little in a military way.
Lieutenant! Lieutenant! Federico! We miss you!
Look who's back, Senor Lieutenant.
Car's in good shape. How's this one?
He's okay. Okay, number one.
And having any trouble with the war?
No, here in Rosino, the ambulance company has no trouble with the war. But up there, the war is bad. Always bad.
Yeah, I know how you feel.
Give me my hat, I go play with the girl.
Where? Show me the garden, and I go play.
I see nothing's changed. How are you, M.C.? And you, Imo? Still causing trouble?
Aye, Signor Lieutenant. It is Pacini who keeps mooning. You know what he told me about you yesterday? He said, the lieutenant, he don't come back.
He's wrong. I said you don't come back because Americans, they too smart.
Not all of them, maybe. I think I'll check in. Looks like you get along better without me.
No, it's better to have an officer to complain about. Here, take these things in Signor Lieutenant's quarters.
Come in.
Lieutenant Henry reporting back for duty, sir.
You will never learn. It's not like this. Like this. You're back in good time. We expect to get a road through the snow in a few weeks, and then we move. Glad you're back, Lieutenant.
Thank you, Major Stampy.
Your chances improved, the doctor. God must have heard my prayers for you.
Check.
Oh.
What do you say, Father, if after you die you find out there is no God?
I shall keep the bad news to myself, Major.
Behold! <Hey! laughs>
The puppy returns. Did you have a nice permission, Federico? You're looking very well.
Lying is a sin, Father. Lieutenant Henry looks terrible. One more kiss, no, and it'll fall apart.
What's new? I hear from Major Stampy we're almost ready to go.
Yes, so we march up the Alps, down the Alps, capture Austria, and finish the war.
By God's mercy.
Ah, a stubborn fellow. 2 years in the war, and he still pretends there is a God of mercy. A coffee?
No, thanks.
Did you see much of interest, Federico?
Well, I saw some fine churches, Father.
From the outside, I hope.
Perhaps someday, when you have time, Federico, you'll enter one. God is patient. Tell me, did you go fishing in Abruzzi? And did you see my family?
I'm sorry, Father. I meant to go to the Abruzzi, but things came up in Naples, and we'll go together someday. Perhaps Rini will go with us.
Yes. Unbelievers are sometimes devout fishermen.
How are things at the hospital, Rini?
Since you went away, nothing. Jaundice, pneumonia, a few self-inflicted wounds, and of course, venereal diseases. Always harder to evade than enemy bullets. But tell me, I can wait no longer. What kind of a time did you have?
Oh, great.
Many beautiful girls?
Enough.
At your age, I never spoke that word.
I think perhaps we should finish our game tomorrow, Major.
You are a good priest, Father Gully, but still a priest. I shall be happy to beat you tomorrow.
Till tomorrow, Major. Federico.
So long, Father.
Now,
where did you go and what did you do? Tell me everything at once.
I went everywhere. Milan, Florence, Rome, Naples, Taormina.
You talk like a timetable. Tell me, where was the most beautiful adventure?
Milan.
Ah, maybe because it was first.
She played the piano beautifully.
There is nothing like talent. I remember in Verona once, a lady artist, a contortionist.
Shut up.
I bore my friend, forgive me. However, I have something of interest. Here we have a big improvement in the war situation. We have beautiful English girls.
Wonderful.
Yes, the British have opened a new hospital near Orsino. I am now in love with one of the nurses, Miss Barkley. I have even thought of marrying Miss Barkley, but I must confess she has one drawback. Her attitude is uncooperative.
You must be slipping.
No,
but she's very strange, very moody. Who knows? She might even prefer you to me.
You will meet her tomorrow. Have you any money? 50 lire.
My wallet.
I must make on Miss Barkley the impression of a man of sufficient wealth. You are my great and good friend and financial protector.
Don't overdo it.
In case I change my mind about Miss Barkley, I will need this for the Villa Rosa. Poor girls, they have missed me.
Mm. You and 50 lira.
And you? Carmelina told me, if Federico does not come back soon, we hang the Villa Rosa in black bunting.
Oh, shut up about dames.
I can see you had a successful vacation. Two new ones. England is a great country. Good morning, miss.
Good morning.
I would like... Excuse me. Miss Barkley? Good morning.
Good morning, Major.
May I present my young American friend, Lieutenant Frederick Henry?
How do you do?
Hello.
Isn't it rather odd for an American to be in the Italian army?
Well, it's not really the army. It's only the ambulance.
Oh, the ambulance is a very important service.
It's very odd, though. Why did you do it?
Oh, I missed out on a job as war correspondent. I didn't particularly want to kill anybody, so I tried the Red Cross to have a look.
To have a look?
Yes, I may want to do some writing. They assigned me to the auto ambulance. End of story.
With me, it's a different story. I am a lover of mankind.
Major Rinaldi?
Yes?
Dr. Gates would like very much to see you if you have the time.
Yes, I have time. Will you pardon me?
Will you follow me, please, Doctor?
With pleasure.
What's the stick?
Belonged to a boy who was killed last year.
Oh, I'm sorry.
He was a very nice boy. He was going to marry me, and he was killed in the Somme.
Oh, it was a mean battle.
His mother sent me the little stick. They returned it with his things.
Were you engaged long?
8 years. We grew up together.
Why did you marry him?
I don't know. I was a fool not to. Have you ever loved anyone?
Off and on. You have beautiful hair.
I was going to cut it all off when he died.
That would have been a shame.
I wanted to do something for him. He could have had anything he wanted if I had known. I would have married him or anything. I didn't, because I thought it would be worse for him to go to war if we were lovers. Then, of course, he was killed. That was the end of it.
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, yes, that's the end of it. It's very beautiful here. Is it true they're going to have an offensive?
So I've heard.
Then we'll have some work. There's no work now.
Done nursing long?
Since the end of 15. I started when he did. I remember having a silly idea he might come to the hospital where I was. With a saber cut, I suppose, and a bandage round his head.
Doesn't happen like that.
No, he didn't have a saber cut. They blew him all to bits. Do you suppose it will always go on?
No.
What's to stop it?
It'll crack somewhere.
Really doesn't matter. We die anyway.
It takes a while.
You think so? Will you excuse me? I have to go now.
Miss Barker. I have been thinking about Miss Barkley. She has beauty and mystery, but she is not for us. Miss Barkley is not only a woman, she is a problem. It is not a good mixture.
Your lectures throw me off.
Well, gentlemen, I have news.
Tomorrow morning it takes our rain or shine, we advance.
We advance in the morning, and here I am wasting my time with a billiard ball, come puppy. With this news, in half an hour, it will be impossible to get into the Villa Rosa with a shoehorn.
You go on, I'm not in the mood.
This is madness. Tomorrow night we will be in the Alps, freezing. You'll need a few warm memories.
I am stupid, the British.
You are going to call on Miss Barkley in spite of all my warnings. Father Gully, I need your help.
Yes, Major.
Please tell our young friend that if he sees Miss Barkley three times, he'll have to marry her. Tell him. It is a British law.
And that is not all. After marriage, children. There is no end to the disasters the British can bring down on our Federico.
I am hardly in a position to discourage marriage, Major.
Are you coming, puppy? I offer you a last reprieve.
I'll see you tomorrow in the parade.
All right. But if all does not go well, you know where I am. Good night, gentlemen.
Good night, Major.
Miss Berkeley will be down directly.
Thank you very much. Look like a mausoleum.
What did you say?
I said these busts look like a cemetery. Bad for the patients, I should think.
I think the busts are rather handsome. By the way, Lieutenant, I assume you know that our girls are not permitted to leave the grounds during the evening.
Oh?
The Italians do not approve of women being so near the front.
Oh, well, that's pretty silly of them, isn't it?
No. I'm inclined to think they're quite right.
Miss Barkley. Is there any place we can go?
Why?
Well, I'd like to see you.
Well, I suppose we could walk in the garden. Unless it rains.
Well, it's not raining now. Certainly have difficult rules for you nurses.
I'm not really a nurse. I'm something called VAD.
What's the difference?
A nurse is like a doctor. It takes a long time to be one. A VAD is a shortcut for war only.
Well, a lot of things are for war only.
Why did you want to see me?
Isn't that rather obvious?
You mean to have a look?
You're nice looking at.
Frankly, I didn't like your attitude about the war. Some people joined up for other reasons.
You mean a better world and all that?
Yes. Seems rather foolish to you, doesn't it?
You mustn't take things too hard. It's a short life at best.
Yes, I think that too.
Then why not enjoy it? Let's drop the war.
It's very hard. There's no place to drop it.
Well, let's drop it anyway.
Please.
Why not?
It's so meaningless.
No, it's not.
People who don't even know each other, I don't like it. I never have.
Please.
I'm sorry.
It's all right.
I'm dreadfully sorry. I just couldn't stand the nurse's evening off aspect of it. I didn't mean to hurt you. I did hurt you, didn't I?
No harm done. It's happened before.
Oh, you poor man. You mean girls usually slap you?
Well, not always.
And you don't mind when they do?
It's more interesting when they don't. Especially when they're as beautiful as you are.
You don't have to say a lot of nonsense. I said I was sorry.
Well, I suppose I might have waited until we knew each other. If only there'd been time.
You're leaving?
We all are.
When?
In the morning.
closer.
You're trembling.
It's nothing.
What is it?
It's nothing, really.
Tell me.
It's only that I've always been afraid of the rain.
Why?
I don't know.
Tell me.
Don't make me.
Tell me.
I'm afraid of the rain because sometimes I see myself dead in it. Catherine in the night.
I've come back to Catherine in the night.
Oh, darling, you have come back, haven't you?
Yes.
I love you so. It's been awful. Funny, really, happening to me like this. Not with someone I loved for years and years, but with someone I've just met, a stranger. Your name is Frederick Henry, isn't it?
Don't talk that way, please. You're so sweet.
You don't have to play any games or say anything foolish.
I'm not playing any games. I'm in love with you.
I wasn't kissing you. I thought... Sounds mad. I thought he'd come back to me in the night.
Catherine, darling.
Catherine. You don't pronounce it very much alike. But you're a very nice boy. I'm glad you're so nice. But you don't have to pretend you love me. That's over for the evening.
I'm not pretending.
You see, I'm not mad, and I'm not gone off. It's only a little sometimes. Now you can go off to war and forget all about this.
I'll come back to you.
Please, you make it worse. I hope the advance is not too difficult and that you don't get hurt.
Please, don't go away like this.
Good night.
Sorry, Papa, but we must leave.
Come
the wheel.
Hills a long time.
Poor baby. It will seem longer to you.
Do you think we have to capture all the Alps?
You sound as if Miss Barkley had been very cooperative.
Shut up.
Tell me, it will make you feel better. Did she?
Shut up.
You will see. I am a man of extreme delicacy. Did she?
If you want to be my friend, shut up.
I don't want to be your friend. I am your friend. An envious one.
It's a long time since I had anyone to say goodbye to.
Change their mind. You think they like to attack?
No, nobody likes to attack.
I like to attack.
Then you're stupid.
Hey, the great Bastille. Read his book. Knows everything.
Better than knowing nothing.
Everybody's a stupid. Fighting is stupid. The war is stupid.
He's right. He's right. What are we doing here?
Field hospitals, dear Lieutenant.
There's your sawmill, Doctor.
Good luck up there.
See you again, Major.
Fanello, I'll drive for a while. Mussini, you and Imo, hop in the back.
Thank you. is a good, the blessing, no?
Can't hurt. Turn the ambulances around before you come in. Better fill the gas tanks, too.
Yes, sir.
Hey, we ought to clean the plug.
Yes, that will win the war.
Very fine. We sleep in the snow.
Beg your pardon, Captain. Thought I'd come up and have a look.
Our front lines are just below. The enemy is on that ridge facing us. Supply depot.
I better get down. Looks like we'll be busy.
Take the cable car.
Signor Lieutenant, you're not far from the hospital.
Lieutenant,
How's the man on top, Signor Lieutenant?
He's dead, I think.
Almost there.
How are you, baby?
What do you think?
The pain hasn't started yet.
A good thing to know.
A present for you, puppy.
The best cognac in Italy.
What's happening with the mountain? We've taken it yet?
50,000 Italians are now freezing triumphantly on his top.
Oh, Father Gall is here with his breath of heaven.
Hello, Federico.
Hello, Father.
Our puppy is going to be all right.
Ah, I am happy to hear that.
I have other good news. Lieutenant Harry will be moved to the new American hospital in Milan.
No, Rini. I want to be sent to Arsino.
It is not in my hands. All wounded Americans have been ordered to Milan. Why should you want to be?
I am very stupid. It is not geography. It is Miss Barkley.
I'm going to Arsino.
Relax. I will see what can be done. Between Father Galli and me, we will move heaven and earth to send Miss Barkley to Milan. Orderly?
Yes, Major.
Lieutenant Henry is the illegitimate son of President Wilson. Keep the bogus of him.
You are not in pain?
Feels better.
I will pray for your quick recovery.
I hope he hears you.
He hears if you love him. Perhaps from Milano you'll go home.
You too. To the Abruzzi country. Next time I'll join you there.
Yes, we'll go fishing together in a stream below our house.
There's a river up in Wisconsin.
There are fine rivers everywhere. In Abruzzi, perhaps among the best. And the people, kind, with a smile for God. The springtime is the most beautiful in Italy. But fall is even more lovely. Sleep well, my friend, and may God bring you to your river.
The porta. Where did he go? There you are.
Yeah, big surprise.
Stop it here.
Ow! That's my sore leg, you fool!
Excuse me.
Watch what you're doing.
Excuse me.
Go easy.
Don't worry. We'll get you upstairs.
Alive. Easy now. Oh!
You want to feed? Oh! You got to put the racket down.
I can't.
I help you.
No. 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 Hey.
Hey.
Stop it.
He fits now.
Sorry, Lieutenant. No room.
My leg. Put my leg up.
America's lots of trouble.
You got any idea where you're going?
I think they have some beds up here.
Nobody here. What do we do?
I'll find somebody.
Good idea.
Here she is.
Lieutenant Henry?
Yeah.
You're our first patient. Your doctor in Orsino notified me of your coming. I'm Miss Van Kampen, hospital superintendent.
How do you do?
This is Miss Ferguson.
How do you do?
Hi. The room at the end of the hall, Porter.
Are there any other nurses here?
Just Miss Ferguson and myself. I think we're quite enough for one patient.
Do you expect any other nurses?
Just the two of us. That bed.
Oh! Hey, you fool! Come on.
Sorry, Lieutenant. Excuse me, Lieutenant, sorry. So...
Get out of here!
Undress and bathe him, Miss Ferguson, and bring a nightgown for him.
I'll undress and bathe myself, thank you.
Nonsense. Would you like to use the bedpan?
No! When's the doctor get here?
When he gets back. We've telephoned to Le Como for him.
I'm hungry. How's the food?
We find it quite satisfactory.
Can I have wine with my meals?
No! Open your mouth. Let's see how sick you really are.
I'm not sick, I'm wounded. I need a drink. Why can't I have it before the doctor gets here?
Because I said absolutely not. Now, that's rather infantile. Turn him over, Miss Ferguson. Let's see if he can break it that way.
Get it?
Yes, sir. I ran the blockade. Now turn away.
I'm over 21.
Here.
It's a pity. They were very becoming.
Mm-hmm. Now don't let Ben Campen catch you guzzling on that. We'll both get life.
Did you find out anything about Miss Barkley?
Yes. Yes, indeed.
What? What'd you find out?
Oh, look at him. The bedridden Romeo. Miss Barkley is arriving on the 8 o'clock train.
She's coming. You're not kidding.
Boy, she must be something. That's probably the barber. I figured you could use a shave. Always helps the reunion.
Darling.
saying that, please, Catherine. Smooth as piano keys.
Smooth as emery paper.
Is it rough?
No, darling. I was just making fun of you. I have to go now, darling.
I'm crazy in love with you.
You're sure? You're sure you love me?
Very sure.
You'll be good to me, won't you?
Of course I will.
You will, won't you? Because we're going to have a strange life.
Strange?
But it's the only life I want.
It is an honor to attend a friend of the good Rinaldi. I was his chief at the university. From the start, he revealed a talent for female anatomy. Tell me what the x-rays show, please.
The x-ray, lady.
I think it will be safer if we do not open the knee until deformed bodies are incised. And that, as you know, will take between 5 and 6 months.
I'm not lying around like a dummy for 6 months.
Perhaps we will know a little more about how long after our examination. Is she your girl, young man?
I'm her fella.
Ah, I thought so. Injury and death, death and injury. I've been standing over them for 30 years. The war changes the picture a little. Youth instead of age requires my services. What a shame to waste young legs as targets. What does the x-ray of the right kneecap show?
The kneecap is free.
What?
No foreign substance until we come to the calf.
You are mad. I can see the shrapnel with my naked eye.
I'm sorry, Colonel. There is nothing there. All the right leg needs is a few minor probes of the calf.
This is the x-ray of the left leg.
Impossible.
To medical genius, nothing is impossible. Now kindly look at the leg under discussion. The right one, please. And describe its contents. She's a lovely girl. I'll do all your obstetrical work free, up to the third baby. After that, there will be a small fee.
The ankle is curiously swollen and obviously full of foreign bodies.
What ankle?
The right one, here.
That is not an ankle. That's the knee in question.
Of course, I was holding the plate upside down.
A natural mistake.
Next time, Miss Ferguson, hand me the plate in the proper position, right side up.
How about it, Doctor? Do I have to wait 6 months for an operation?
Well, I think we can get to you a little sooner. Say, tomorrow?
Tomorrow?
Yes.
Good work.
We'll meet again at 10 in the morning, young man.
See you on the chopping block. Thank you, sir.
I leave you in good hands. Love is the best medicine. Good evening, happy people.
Good night, Doctor.
Good evening, Doctor.
Oh, Doctor, thank you for your assistance.
If I can be of any further help to you, Doctor, don't hesitate to call on me. I have duties. I have to get you ready.
Oh.
I don't want anyone else to touch you. I know I'm silly, but I'll be furious if they got you. Now, just a little advice. When you're going under the ether, don't think about us, because people get very blabby under an anesthetic. Think of something very unpleasant, or say your prayers. That'll create a splendid impression.
I won't talk. Not a chance.
No, don't brag. You're very sweet. You don't have to brag. Oh, you have such a lovely temperature.
I like yours better.
I'm awfully proud of your temperature.
Maybe all our children will have fine temperatures.
Our children will probably have beastly temperatures.
Tonight, huh? Please.
For tonight, the chart indicates a few drugs, a bath, and an emetic. Nothing else.
He'll be out of the ether in a few minutes. Couldn't ask for a better operation.
Don't jiggle him.
Catherine, come here.
Van Campen is listening. You better muzzle your Romeo.
Kathy, come here.
My patient seems to have a one-track mind. If she hears him, you're sunk.
Kathy, come here.
Can you imagine anyone making wine because it tastes like strawberries?
Why shouldn't they? It sounds splendid.
But it doesn't even taste like strawberries.
Next time, if I don't seem too ungrateful, I'd like a little brandy.
No, no. It's much too strong for you.
Tell you what I'll do, Kat. Get me another bottle of brandy and I'll marry you. Oh,
you mean that just for a bottle of brandy you'd make an honest woman of me?
No. As a matter of fact, I'm going to marry you even if you do bring me this vile stuff.
No. We're not going to be married.
Yes, we are.
Darling, I'd rather marry you than do anything in the world. If we get married, they'll send me away.
Who says?
Wives are not allowed at the front.
Aren't you embarrassed about not being married?
No. See, darling, it would mean everything to me if I had any religion. But you're my only religion. You're all I've got. It's going to rain.
Cat, darling.
It's all nonsense. I'm not afraid of the rain. I'm not afraid of the rain. God, I wish I were.
See the two new patients?
No.
A head wound and a hernia. It's interesting.
I'm grateful for them. I was terrified they'd send me back.
How's your hero?
He walked down the corridor three times. Then he wanted to try running. I had to stop him forcibly. We're going boating next week. I think that will be good for him, don't you, Freddy?
Dandy.
I went all over Milan looking for American oatmeal. It's really only gruel, but he insists it has to come out of an American package. Luckily, he's much more tolerant about bacon.
They're all alike.
What do you mean?
I mean, they've all got habits. The chief one being, they don't want to get married.
He's already proposed.
Proposed what?
To marry me.
Well, well. I take it all back about his being a love him and leave him boy. Congratulations.
No, thank you, but getting married would only mean being separated. You know the regulations.
Are you crazy? No, don't answer. Listen, in a couple of months, your Frederico walks out of here on a pair of good legs and leaves you behind.
It won't be like that.
Listen, honey, that's also regulations. Every soldier feels he has the right to walk out on any dame he captures while in the service of his country.
Please stop before you make me angry.
Well, get angry. It may pump some sense into your head.
What is the noise about, Miss Barkley?
I was just saying that the only thing that can help the Allies is for the Americans to come over here and to come over here quick. Our English lady doesn't seem to approve of that statement.
I will not tolerate a disturbance in this hospital of any kind.
Yes, Miss Van Camp.
And if you don't like Americans, Miss Barkley, you will please keep it to yourself.
Yes, Miss Van Camp.
Does Miss Barkley smoke?
No, I don't. I mean, no, she doesn't.
Hold your nose when you jump. Nobody.
Except me, of course.
You're the first and only.
Oh, come. How many others, really?
None.
You're lying to me.
A little.
It's all right. That's what I want you to do. Keep right on lying to me. When does a girl say how much it costs?
I don't know.
Of course not. Does she say she loves him? Tell me that. I want to know that.
Yes, if he wants her to.
Does he say he loves her? Tell me, please. It's important.
He does if he wants to.
But you never did. Tell me the truth, please.
No.
You wouldn't. I knew you wouldn't. Oh, I love you, darling. The girl just says what the man wants her to.
Well, not always, but...
But I will. I'll say just what you wish, and I'll do what you wish. Then you'll never want any other girls. Will you?
Never.
I'll do what you want, and I'll say what you want. Then I'll be a great success. Won't I?
You're lovely and wonderful.
There isn't any me anymore. Just what you want. Ask for it.
You.
Miss Barkley? Where is Miss Barkley?
Oh.
Miss Ferguson, have you seen Miss Barkley? I've been looking everywhere for that girl.
Well, I'll tell her you want to see her.
Where is she?
In the kitchen, I'm sure. She always insists on doing all the dishes. Works like a truck horse.
Thank you.
Detoured to the kitchen. You've got about 1 minute.
Thanks.
Ben Camp. Give me the paper.
Oh,
Babe Ruth in the box. The Red Sox again clobbered the wilting Senators today, 5-0. It was a dreary session, except for a triple play in the ninth stanza that led to the groaning exodus from the sweltering Washington bleachers.
Miss Barkley, the bedsteads in Ward B need polishing.
Yes, ma'am.
I don't understand why you feel it necessary to remain in the room when the patient is asleep.
I didn't know he was asleep. I was reading to him.
Reading to the patients is not part of your duties, Miss Barkley.
I'm very sorry. I thought...
You may leave the paper here. He can finish that important dispatch by himself.
Throwing a party tonight at the Grand Hotel.
Let's see if we can pick ourselves a winner in the next race, huh? What's the matter, Kath?
Nothing, darling.
Well, now, you're not depressed because we lost the last race, huh?
Certainly not.
Then what's wrong?
Nothing, really.
Yes, there is. Tell me, please.
I don't want to. I'm afraid it'll make you unhappy. A worry.
It won't. It doesn't worry you.
All right. I'm ready to have a baby.
Well, that is news.
You're not upset. Please, please don't worry.
I only worry about you.
Please don't. Everybody has babies. It's a natural thing.
You're pretty wonderful.
Oh, no, I'm not. But I won't be any trouble after this 1 minute. I've known for some time. Haven't I been a good girl till now? You never suspected.
Well, that settles one thing. We'll get married tomorrow.
No, please. That's why I didn't tell you before. I didn't want you to feel trapped. Tell me you don't feel trapped.
You always feel trapped, biologically.
Always isn't a pretty word.
Oh, I'm sorry, Kat.
It's all right. You see, I've never had a baby. I've tried to be the way you want. You talk about always.
Kat, I could cut out my tongue. Darling, I'm delighted. Honestly, I am. Now, I'll dig up a minister or the mayor, maybe.
Oh, no, please. I'd ship me straight back to England. Maybe the war will be over before you have to go back. The important thing is for us to be together now. Just as long as we can.
Attention! Attention! A special communique from the Zonta Front. In spite of desperate resistance by the flower of the Austrian army, our troops have reached the summits of San Gabriele and San Marco. Rally to Italy!
Isn't that fine wedding music? I, Catherine, take thee, Frederick, for my wedded husband.
To have and to hold. Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Where did you get these bottles, Nino? I demand an answer. They're from Lieutenant Henry's room, aren't they?
Please, they are empty bottles.
As I understand.
You won't ever leave me for anybody else, will you?
Oh, darling.
plenty of rules, but I'm very faithful. I'll be so faithful, you'll be sick of me.
Lieutenant Henry, I've long suspected you of using this hospital as a private place of diversion.
Miss Barkley is no diversion. We're...
Are these your bottles?
Yes. One's brandy and the other one's Kumo. They're empty.
Just a moment, Miss Barkley. You know our rules, therefore you know what to expect. As for you, Lieutenant, you're obviously no longer a convalescent. I'm notifying headquarters that you're ready to return to active duty. This very night.
Tonight? It's almost 11.
Still have a few hours.
You'll be skiing in St. Moritz soon.
We'll go sometime.
Like us.
I wish they had some place to go.
It might not do them any good.
Oh, I don't know. Everybody ought to have some place to go.
I feel better now. I felt terrible when we started.
We always feel good when we're together.
We always will be together.
Yes. Except that I'm leaving a little after two.
Don't think about it, darling. Do you have to go back for your things?
No. Porter's taking my bags and saving me a place.
Good. After you leave, I'll go back and get my things. How's your leg? Getting tired?
No. Let's not walk too long, huh?
Let's go somewhere.
Good. Let's go in there.
I'd like a room, suite, if you have one.
For how long?
Getting a train in a few hours.
Oh, yes, I understand. Well, we have no suites, but we can give you... number 15, our mirror room. Very popular. With private bath.
Fine.
No luggage?
No luggage.
10 lire in advance, please. Would Monsieur and Madame care for some wine? We have some very good French champagne.
All right. Some sandwiches, too.
Your key. Arturo!
Shame on you. Shame.
Just the right atmosphere, isn't it?
What's the matter, darling?
I never felt like a whore before.
You're not a whore.
I know it, darling, but it isn't nice to feel like one. Come here, please. Come here, please, darling. I'm a good girl again.
You're my fine girl.
I'm certainly yours.
You're a fine, simple girl.
Yes, I am a simple girl. But no one ever understood it except you.
I didn't think so at first. I thought you were a crazy girl.
I was a little crazy. But I wasn't crazy in any complicated way. I didn't confuse you, did I, darling?
You did a little. Here.
Yeah. Wine is a grand thing. It makes you forget all the bad you do.
And have some more.
Vice is a wonderful thing, too. The people who go in for it seem to have good taste about it. The red plush is really splendid. Just the thing.
I don't know how a room like this would be for waking up in the morning with a hangover.
But everything we do seems so innocent and simple. Wine is lovely. But it's given my father gout very badly.
Have you a father?
Yes. He has gout. You won't ever have to meet him. Haven't you a father?
Mm-mm. Stepfather.
Will I like him?
You won't ever have to meet him. But he's very generous. I can draw drafts on him whenever I please.
That's good. Oh, we have such a fine time together. I don't take any interest in anything else anymore. I feel very married to you. It makes me so happy.
But at my back, I always hear time's winged chariot hurrying near.
It's time to go.
Don't worry, darling. We're fine until now. Now you're worrying.
I won't.
How often will you write?
Every day. Do they read your letters? I'll make them very confusing.
But not too confusing.
I'll just make them a little confusing. I hate to leave our fine house.
So do I.
We're never settled in our home very long.
We will be.
I'll have a fine home for you when you come back.
Poor young Catherine. Go, darling. Really?
All right. You go first.
Sick with worry about you. Where will you go? What will you do?
Please don't worry about me, darling. I've plenty of money and I'll find some nice place. Maybe on the lakes. It ought to be beautiful in the autumn.
Where will you have the baby?
Oh, that's a long way off. You're not to worry about that one bit. Anyway, people have babies everywhere.
Yes, that's true.
Into the station with you.
No, darling, I'd rather you didn't.
Oh, darling, please.
It'll be easier to say goodbye here.
Oh, darling. Thank you. Thank you for everything.
I love you.
I love you. I adore you.
Take good care of yourself and young Catherine.
I will. And you. You promise you'll come back to us.
I will. Take the lady back to the American hospital.
Thank you. Oh, hello. How are you?
All right, sir. Thank you. And you?
You couldn't believe how bad it's been. But it will be worse. We can expect the Germans on this front now that the Russians have made a separate peace with them. What about your countrymen? Now that your country's in it, will there be many Americans here beside yourself?
They're training an army of 10 million.
The French front will get them all. We'll never get any down here. We'll face the Germans alone.
Many of them, do you think?
5, 10 divisions, who knows? But I suppose we'll know soon enough.
I'm afraid the Germans are pretty good.
It isn't that they're better men. They've got a better war machine. They've been building it gun by gun for years, while we Italians have been practicing civilization. Now, of course, civilization is not very useful. There's only one of your ambulances left in town. The others I have sent to Capretto. You know Capretto?
Yes, sir. A nice little town with a fountain in the square.
I doubt that the fountain is still there. Better go and see your friend Rinaldi.
Anything wrong?
He's at the summer and fall of it, I can tell you.
Thank you, sir.
Father Galli.
Federico, how are you? I am glad to see you.
Hello, Father.
Your wounds are all healed?
All healed.
You will come back at a break time.
Sounds a little noisy.
Oh, hello, baby.
Vini, how are you?
How's the leg?
Working.
Sit down. Let me look at it. Hello, Father.
Hello, Major.
...80% mobility. It's a crime to send you back. Now, tell me about everything, Papi.
Nothing much to tell. How are you?
How am I? I dig bullets out of blood. I cut off arms, legs, the side of a face. I am becoming a remarkable surgeon. We will celebrate my genius. We'll get drunk, Papi.
No, I'm tired, really.
We'll get drunk and go meet some girls with loud voices. And then we'll feel fine. 7 stars. War booty from San Gabriele. Cognac, Father?
No, thanks.
Saint Paul said, take a little wine for your stomach's sake.
Yes, I know.
Father Galli knows. But Father Galli is better than Saint Paul. Saint Paul was around at the Cesar. Isn't that true, Federico?
I never discuss a saint after dark.
So, you've gone over to the priests. I have to bait this priest alone. Ah! The priests always win. Everybody ends up on their knees, except the miserable Rinaldi. He remains true to the devil.
No, Rinaldi, you're all right. You're all right. To all of us.
You are changed. You drink differently. Are you married?
Not yet.
Still in love?
Yes.
Same girl?
Yes.
Is she good to you?
Shut up.
All right. To hell with love.
He's been under a strain.
The fifth horseman of the apocalypse. He destroys the liver and makes the hand shake. A surgeon's hand shaking inside a man's belly. Very fine. I drink to open bellies.
You ought to have a leave.
He wants to get rid of me because I have a disease.
Is that true, Father? No. It's in his mind. His mind is sick.
It's true! It's true. Everybody has it. The whole world has it.
He's been working too hard day and night. There are not enough doctors.
Tell me about Miss Barkley, Papi. I want to hear something pretty. Tell me something pretty.
I'll speak to the colonel about a leave for him. Good night, Federico. Good night, Father.
back. Go back. Clear the road. Come on, hurry up. Clear the road.
Sorry, Lieutenant. Turn around and go back.
What for, sir?
Orders. We must clear the road all the way to Orsino and fast.
Right.
Let's go.
I don't understand.
I don't either, but I can make a pretty good guess.
To the retreat line.
Do I take any wounded?
Retreat? Where did you get that information, Lieutenant?
From the division, sir.
It's a lie. There is no retreat. The division has orders to hold the line no matter what happens.
I work under the medical corps. Where it tells me to go, I go. But please get your orders straight.
Caporetto is lost. 15 German divisions have broken through. All three of our armies are in retreat.
I'm not surprised.
We are evacuating. Every doctor is ordered to go with the army.
And what about the wounded?
It is better for the wounded not to move them. The ambulances will be used to carry medical equipment.
I am not equipment. I am a man. I'm staying.
I repeat, division orders. Every doctor's to go with the army.
Yes, sir. Orders are a noble thing. I must not disappoint the division. Better to disappoint.
Come on, Rini, you're sick.
Leave the wounded and the dying. They shall be abandoned without hesitation.
Excuse me, Father. The Germans will be along in a few hours. Come with us. There's room in the ambulance.
How are the men here?
They'll pulverize the town before they come in.
They're dying in need.
What about the Abruzzi and the chestnut woods and the river?
Perhaps you've forgotten it.
You're someone to remember, Father.
I am ordered to leave, Father Galli. But you have better orders from God to remain. I salute your commanding officer.
May his blessing go with you.
Bye, Father.
Laudate Dominum, omnes gentes. Laudate omnes homines. Quoniam confirmata est super nos misericordia eius. Et veritas Domini manu in aperto.
Denote cilia dell'ave del ciel. Ave, ave, ave.
Seem to remember. Yes. Make way for Rinaldi, who is saving his skin.
Shut up, Rini. You're full of fever.
The Gemma spy is beating on us. The dead man spits on us. That's what we deserve.
It's hopeless. Bad luck, Rini. We're walking. Where's Bonello?
I don't know. I was asleep when he got off the ambulance.
Just deserted, huh? Anyway, you stay close to us.
Yes, Mr. Lieutenant.
Come on, Rini, it's going to be a long haul.
Father Galli stayed. The priest stayed, but Rinaldi lost.
Come on, no nonsense.
Only loves are untrue to me. What good are we to Italy? We are fit only for surrender. Let the Germans collect the garbage with a shovel.
You're under arrest. What are you talking about? Don't you know you can't touch an officer? Shoot him if you resist.
What's the meaning of all this?
Who are you?
Battle police.
What do you mean arresting Major Rinaldi?
We heard him. He's a German infiltrator preaching defeat.
He's just the opposite, you fool.
Take him away.
What's your division?
19th.
The 19th division was pulled out 10 days ago. You are a German and Italian uniform.
This man's a spy. Guilty of spreading panic and preaching surrender. I request he be sentenced to death.
I placed the accused in the hands of the court martial.
In the name of His Majesty, the court finds the prisoner guilty and orders him shot.
No, wait. Wait! I will talk! I will talk! Wait!
Keep your hands off me. I need no assistance.
your name, rank, and birthplace.
My name is Alessandro Rinaldi. My rank is that of a coward. My birthplace, I will not disgrace by naming it.
You have medical corps insignia.
Oh, forgive me. I forgot to tear it off.
No, no, Rini, stop it. Tell him the truth.
You were spreading disorder. You called our army garbage. You were telling our men to surrender.
They ran. I ran with them. I am a doctor, needed by our dying men. And they ran. Dispose of me. Garbage inspector.
Let me talk for him.
Silence.
Come, you heroes. Shoot a coward and win the war.
You are a German infiltrator or a confessed deserter? In the name of His Majesty, you're ordered to be shot.
You're mad! Major Rinaldi's sick! He's sick, I tell you! Colonel. Colonel. You must listen to me. He's one of the best surgeons in your army.
Our army? Your name, rank, and birthplace.
Goodbye, Papi. I'm joining Father Galli.
No.
Answer the question. You're not an Italian. You're wearing an Italian uniform, but you do not even know the Italian salute.
What are you doing here?
Don't ask me any questions.
Look at you. What are you doing in Muscat?
Where's Catherine?
Now tell me you're wounded.
No, I'm not wounded.
This time I hope it's a hole in your head.
Where is she?
She's in the mess you got her into. That's where she is.
I can't stand here arguing with you, Ferguson. Please, before they grab me. Please, Ferguson. Where is she?
In Stracer. Hotel Valeria, room 7. Lieutenant Henry, are you wounded? What are you doing in those filthy clothes?
Miss Van Cabin, before you do anything, let me tell you...
You don't have to tell me anything. You're a deserter.
Not in the way you think. I had to do what
Of course you had to. Cowards always run.
Now, are you going to give yourself up, or shall I do it for you? Carabinieri!
Oh, firing squad for me.
Carabinieri!
Doctor, I'm not sick. At least, not that way.
Then what is it? I don't understand.
It's just that I'm through. I'm through with the war. I made a separate peace.
You mean you deserted?
Yes. I'm a deserter.
It's not your army. Or your country. Tell me what happened.
All kinds of hell. Rinaldi's dead. Oh. They killed him. A firing squad. I better not tell you about it.
No, I want to hear.
He was sick and talking like a madman. And the firing squad blew his brains out. I was next. You can't win an argument with a firing squad.
Of course you can't. And you're not going to try. You're not going back.
I'm not against them. They're the good ones, the brave ones. I wish them all the luck. They deserve it. But it's not my show anymore.
Of course it isn't. We're together, that's all that matters. The rest is something else, far away. Just us. Us.
You're going to sleep for a week.
The sleeve's a bit short. It was the best I could do. You are a little tall for your age, darling.
It's a fine outfit.
We'll just stay right here. It's practically deserted this time of the year. And cheap.
Couldn't be nicer.
Now, let's see. Shall I get you some papers?
No, I don't want to read the papers.
Oh, I'm sorry. Was it so bad you don't want even to read about it, darling?
Yes, it was bad.
Oh, I wish I'd been with you so I would know about it, too. Darling, what will happen if they find you?
I'll shoot them.
You wouldn't. And what would they do to you?
They'd shoot me, of course.
Then we can't stay here. We can go to Switzerland.
Oh, please, darling. I'm tired of even thinking about it.
But the border's very near.
Yes, and they have guards across it like a picket fence.
We can go across the lake. We'll borrow one of those boats.
They'd turn us in if we even asked.
Then we'll steal one. We can send it back.
It's over 20 miles.
You can do it. I know you can.
What about the patrol boats? They'd spot us sure.
Not if we go at night. Darling, don't you see? We've got to get out of here. Fast. Tonight. Please.
All right. You're a grand girl.
I hope nobody saw us.
I'm more worried about the patrol boats.
Hands are sore is all.
I think I hear something.
It's a patrol boat.
Turning.
must be close to the border.
Oh, darling, I was terrified.
So was I.
Oh.
Are you all right?
Darling, I've never been more all right in my whole life.
Switzerland.
Oh, darling, darling, it's a lovely country.
Yes, feels good beneath my feet.
Station with you to see you off.
I hope not.
Don't say that. It frightens me. Your hands, your poor hands. We'll buy some ointment. Some magic Swiss ointment.
Forget about my hands. I'm still hungry.
So are we.
Pardon me. I'm Lieutenant Zimmermann. Is that your boat that just came in?
Yes.
What nationality are you?
American. British.
Well, let me see your passport. Why do you come to Switzerland?
We're tourists. My cousin and I want to enjoy the winter sports.
You rowed here from Italy?
Yes, rowing is my favorite sport. I always row when I get the chance.
Indeed. Your cousin, too?
Yes, I love it.
Uh-huh. Cousins with the same taste, with different nationalities, rowing all night across the lake. Very interesting. What have you been doing in Italy?
I've been doing some writing. Picking up local color, you might say.
Mm-hmm. And you, Miss Barkley?
She's been studying art.
Yes, Rubens, Raphael, Rembrandt. You know, things mm-hmm. like that.
How much money have you?
2,500 lira.
2,500 lira? As you're so interested in boating, I can recommend an excellent place. A very small, intimate hotel overlooking the most romantic lake.
That sounds enchanting.
It happens to be owned by my mother. Her name is Madame Zimmermann.
Oh, how nice.
I happen to have one of my mother's cards here. Oh. Take the luggage and get these tourists a cab.
Yes, sir.
Your passports will be kept by the police. I regret this, but it is necessary under the circumstances. There'll be a return after a time.
But you're sure we can stay without being bothered?
I'm certain you and your cousin will find my mother's hotel very comfortable. Service.
Thank you, Lieutenant.
It's a great country.
And so practical.
You may come in now, Mr. Henry. Your wife is an excellent advertisement for Switzerland. She has had only 6 weeks of our fine air, but she couldn't be healthier if she were born Swiss. Not one wrong symptom, a beautiful expectant mother. You should be very pleased, Mr. Henry.
I am.
I prescribe a little sleep and, of course, some exercise. Mm-hmm. No scaling alpine peaks. Your husband's knee is fine now, but he must be a little careful. We want the child to have a healthy father.
Yes, we want him able to walk the baby.
Well, he will be.
You will have the baby in the spring, the ideal season for beginning.
Thank you, Dr. Emmerich. We'll be seeing you regularly, won't we?
Yes, of course, but do not be concerned. We have babies quite often in Switzerland. Goodbye, Mrs. Emmerich.
Goodbye, Doctor, and thank you. I'm so excited to be healthy. Darling, stop fussing with that silly pie.
What's up?
Little Catherine. She's turning a cartwheel. Want to feel her?
Wow. Doesn't it hurt?
Oh, you idiot. It feels wonderful.
By the way, I got our passports back from the police today. Now we can get married.
No.
Well, I'm sure it would be considered the proper thing to do. Unless you're crazy.
Not as crazy as you think. I'm not going to let you off the hook ever. But I'm not going to startle the whole countryside now by letting them know I'm not married.
We could go to some other village.
Wherever we went, it would be too embarrassing. I show too plainly. I can't be married in this splendid matronly shape.
You'd make a beautiful bride in any shape.
We'll get married as soon as I'm thin again. And everyone will say, what a handsome couple. We'll have orange blossoms, organ music, and somebody to mind the baby.
Come in.
Oh, how nice, Mrs. Zimmerman.
I got to tell you a joke. When my son told me you were coming, he made a mistake. He thought you were cousins. Yes, beer and pretzels for the gentleman. And hot wine and spices for madam.
Oh, thank you.
Happy evening, lady and gentlemen.
Happy evening, Mrs. Zimmerman. Happy evening, Mrs. Zimmerman.
I think I may marry Mrs. Zimmerman.
Oh, she's too good for you.
Here, drink this while it's hot.
Darling, I'm going to cut my hair short. Very short.
No?
Oh, no, when I'm thin again. I'll be thin and I'll have short hair. You're not going to say no, are you?
You can cut it if you want to.
Why? I thought you liked my hair long.
I love it long.
But you said you prefer it short.
I did not.
You hinted it.
I didn't hint anything. I'm just trying to agree with you.
Oh, I wish you wouldn't try to confuse me. I know why you're bored with me. Because I love you too much.
You're mad.
Please don't shout at me.
I'm not shouting. I'm just trying to tell you, you don't bore me. Everything else bores me, but you.
Oh, darling. You mustn't mind me. We really are the same one, and we mustn't misunderstand on purpose.
We won't.
No, but people do. They love each other and they misunderstand on purpose. And they fight and then suddenly they aren't the same one.
We won't fight.
No, we mustn't. Because there's only us two. And in the world, there's all the rest of them. If anything comes between us, we're gone. And then they have us.
They won't get us. Because you're too brave. Nothing ever happens to the brave.
They die, of course.
A coward dies a thousand deaths. The brave but once.
The brave die thousands of times, if they're intelligent.
You're an authority. You're brave.
Oh, no, I'm not. But anyway, I'm not going to cut my hair until after young Catherine is born and I'm thin again. I'm going to cut it off and I'll be a fine new girl for you and you'll fall in love with me all over again.
I love you enough now. What are you trying to do, ruin me?
Yes, I want to ruin you.
Good, that's what I want too. Oh. Say, you know how they go courting in the Alps? They yodel. Huh? Chulale, 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 cuckoo! And if the lady's interested, she yodels back.
Oh? Really? Chulale, chulale, cuckoo, do you?
Together, Deutsche Stunde, Schwestern, Leben, Gute, Wasser, Berg.
That's a hit. Checkmate.
I don't care. I've got your queen.
Darling, the game's over. It's checkmate.
Why? I still have more of these silly pieces than you have. Oh, I wish you liked rummy. It's much more fun. Happy New Year, darling.
To all three of us.
Here's to 1918.
Little Catherine's year.
Do you mind our being alone? Just us on New Year's Eve?
I never feel alone when we're together.
But sometimes a man wants to be alone.
I imagine sometimes a girl wants to be alone, too. And if they love each other, they're jealous of that in each other.
I don't want to be away from you ever.
Me too. My life used to be full of all sorts of things. Now, if you're not with me, I haven't a thing in the world.
Oh, but I'm not any fun for you anymore. I'm just like a big flower barrel.
No, you're not. You're more beautiful all the time.
Just the same, you're going down to town tomorrow and find yourself some gay young playmate.
I don't want to be with anybody else, I tell you.
Yes, you do. And I'm going to start the new year by buying little Catherine's first wardrobe. I'll find out what's necessary. I'll do it tomorrow.
Well, you ought to know. You were a nurse.
But so few of the soldiers had babies in the hospital.
I did.
Oh. Where are you? Where are you?
I'm right here. I've got a sweat.
You sound like a ventriloquist.
You look like a spook in fairyland.
Oh, spook for yourself, darling.
All aboard.
Oh, I don't think I want to ride. I want to walk. It's good for the baby.
The baby does what I say.
Well, may I steer?
Sure, you can steer.
My wife and I lived all alone in a little hut we call our own. She loved gin and I love rum. I tell you, we had lots of fun. Ha ha ha, you and me, little brown jug, don't I love thee? Ha ha ha, you and me, little brown jug, don't I love thee?
Hello. Is it going to take much longer?
No, mister. Don't be impatient. She's doing a beautiful job. And it's very important that I look my best when I meet little Catherine.
I'm sure she'd be very impressed.
Is this your first child, madame? Oh, no. We have two boys. That is wonderful.
And two girls.
Oh, monsieur.
Oh. Hurry up.
She won't come between us, will she? Will she, darling? The little brat?
No, we won't let her. We'll keep her in a tree.
Oh, won't it be fun? There'll be three of us.
Hello, Cat.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine, darling.
I brought your things. Isn't the doctor here yet?
In a few minutes. The pains are coming quite often now. This is a real one. You go away, darling. Go out and get some dinner.
Oh, I couldn't.
I may do this for a long time, the nurse says.
The first labor's usually protracted.
I'd rather stay.
Oh, please go, darling. I think you're just making me self-conscious. I do so want to be a good wife and have this child without any foolishness.
You have plenty of time if you'd like to get some dinner.
No, I'll be just outside. Do you think I could go into the
Yes, I'm sure it will be all right.
Thank you.
Bear down as hard as you can.
I'm having fine pains. That was a very big one. It will be soon now. I can tell.
Yes, my dear. We'll give you some gas to ease the pain.
Oh, I don't want to make any fuss. Darling?
Yes.
I just want to be sure you were here.
I won't leave.
That's a good boy. I have the most wonderful doctor. He's been telling me the most wonderful story. When the pain came too badly, he put me all the way out. He's wonderful. You're wonderful, doctor.
You're dropped.
I know. You shouldn't say it. Give it to me. Give it to me. I'm sorry I go on so long. I thought I would do it so easily. I try as hard as I can. I push down, but it goes away. There it comes. Give it to me. Oh, please, doctor, give me enough to do some good. Stop! Make trouble, and now I'm all gone, and all gone to pieces, and it doesn't work.
Oh, my brave darling.
I'm not brave anymore. I'm all broken.
In a little while.
They just keep it up till they break you.
It'll be over in a little while.
I won't die, will I, darling?
No, I promise you won't.
I don't want to die and leave you, but I get so tired. And I feel I'm going to die.
Nonsense. Everybody feels that.
I always knew I was going to die.
You can't. You won't. I won't let you.
You would not do any such foolishness. You would not die and leave your husband.
Don't mind me, darling. I've just gone all to pieces. Oh, I love you so. I'll be good again.
You'll be all right, Kat. You'll be all right.
You're so good to me.
You will go, please, for a few minutes. I will make an examination.
You can come back afterward, darling. Can't he, doctor?
Yes, I'll send word when he can come back.
Poor cat.
Mr. Henry, the doctor wants to see you.
Is anything wrong? How does it go, doctor?
It doesn't go.
She was so healthy. You said yourself she was.
Yes, I know. But somehow, sometimes nature fails itself.
What do you advise?
There are two things. Either a high forceps delivery, which can tear and be quite dangerous, besides being possibly bad for the child, or a cesarean.
What's the danger of a cesarean?
No greater than the danger of an ordinary delivery. If it were my wife, I would do a cesarean.
What are the after effects?
None. There's only the scar.
What if you just went on and did nothing?
We would have to do something eventually. Mrs. Henry is already losing much of her strength. The sooner we operate now, the safer.
Operate as soon as you can.
I'll go and give the instructions.
Did you tell him he could do it?
Yes.
Isn't that grand? That will all be over in no time. Darling.
Yes, Kat.
Is it raining?
No, I don't think so.
I think it's raining.
Hey, Savoy. Congratulations. Aren't you proud?
He nearly killed his mother.
You may come in now for a moment. Is he all right?
Yes, he's fine.
I'm awfully tired. I like hell.
Madame Henry mustn't talk too much.
You haven't eaten all day, darling. Go and eat something. I'll be all right when you come back.
I'll be back in 15 minutes.
Nice
day. Mr. Henry?
Yes, Doctor.
I'm sorry about the baby.
What about the baby?
The terrible labor, the whole ordeal, it was too much for him. We couldn't start him breathing.
So he's dead.
Yes, we tried everything.
What about her?
She'll be all right, my boy. Come, have a cup of coffee with me. I assure you she'll be all right.
Please, Dr.
Heinrich?
Yes, coffee and brioche. The alcohol, please.
It will be free in 2 minutes.
We'll wait.
It's true. Even the German communique admits it is true.
Yes. A month ago, they said only a miracle could save the Italians.
Well, the miracle has happened. The Italians are holding on the Piave River.
Poor cat. She wanted this baby so much.
The table is ready, Doctor.
I don't understand it. I felt him kick. He was alive inside Catherine. Except the last week. The last week he was quiet. Maybe he was dead all the time.
Drink your coffee, my boy.
Poor kid. Never even had a chance. Maybe it's just as well.
They kill you in the end. Maybe it's better that way than to wind up dead on a muddy road.
You don't know what it's all about. You never have time to learn. They throw you in and tell you the rules, and the first time they catch you off base, they kill you. You can count on that. Stay around and they'll kill you. Poor cat. Poor dear cat. This is the price you pay for sleeping together. She didn't have a bad time when she was pregnant. She had a good time. She was hardly ever sick. She wasn't even very uncomfortable until towards the last. But you never get away with anything. Get away, hell. They get you in the end. Maybe they're gonna get her too. She's not gonna die, is she?
No, no, my boy, I'm sure.
You're sure about the baby too. What if she should die?
She's coming along fine. Don't you worry.
Dr. Heinrich?
Oh, excuse me, Mr. Henry. I'm wanted. Finish your coffee. I'll meet you later at the hospital.
She said she felt like hell. What if she should die? No, she won't die. People don't die in childbirth nowadays. That's what all husbands think. What if she should die? No. She's just having a bad time. That's it. Afterwards, we'll say, what a bad time. And Catherine will say, oh, it really wasn't so bad.
But what if she should die?
But what if she should? But... what if she should?
Oh, Mr. Henry. I just tried to telephone you.
What's wrong?
Madame Henry has had a hemorrhage.
Can I go in?
Not yet.
Is it dangerous?
It is very dangerous.
Please don't let her die. I'll do anything if you won't let her die. Whatever wrong I've done, please, 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 dear God, don't let her die. You took our baby, but don't let her die. Please. Please, dear God, don't. Don't.
Mr. Henry.
You're all right. You're going to be all right.
Don't touch me. Poor darling. You touch me all you want.
You'll be all right, Kat. I know you'll be all right.
I meant to write you a letter to Helen. If anything happened, I didn't do it.
Do you want me to do anything, Kat? Do you want me to send for anybody?
Just you. Say the same things, will you?
No.
I want you to have girls, huh?
I don't want girls.
I'll come and stay with you tonight. Just a dirty trick.
Can I do anything?
No, just leave us alone.
I think it might be better if...
Get out. Both of you.
You're so cold, Kat. Like a statue.
Won't it be fun? There'll be three of us.
I'm not a bit afraid, darling. I just hate it.
Darling, you will be good to me, won't you? You will, won't you? Because we're going to have a strange life. But it's the only life I want.